With every passing year, humans on Earth launch various missions to other planets to learn more about the solar system. Meanwhile, on the ground, astronomers are scanning the skies for potential signs of life in the universe. If we one day discover an intelligent alien existence, it'll constitute one of the greatest scientific moments of all time. But what if it's impossible from the beginning to better human beings? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, are humans the most advanced civilization in the universe? Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content. The famous Drake equation, created in 1961 by Dr. Frank Drake, aims to predict the possible number of technological civilizations there are in our galaxy and universe. The problem, though, is that answers to it vary wildly. To reach a solution, we need to know the number of possible Earth-like planets there are with the right conditions for life, then the fraction of those planets that actually do develop life, then the fraction of those life forms that become intelligent, and then the fraction of those intelligent life forms that develop interstellar communication and reach a comparable level to humankind. The criteria is strict, but the numbers to input are vague, and that makes the Drake equation extremely challenging, nay impossible, to solve right now. For today's question especially, we're then hindered by our own almost certainly limited human perspective, unable to conclusively determine what would count as more advanced than us. We can't really know how advanced life can become yet for a few reasons. First, how rare is it for non-living matter to become alive? This is known as abiogenesis, and refers to the origin of life and how organic compounds managed to form the very first life, and it's an area of study still quite poorly understood. There are a number of theories, some more convincing than others, but no one knows exactly how life initially began, even just on Earth. Then there are the problems and pitfalls of evolution. We know that it's taken billions of years for everything that's alive on this planet right now to get to this point, that it's an incredible but also incredibly slow process. But some theories argue that life more advanced than humans will have had to have developed over an even greater period of time. Generally speaking, though, that's not much of a problem for the universe as a whole. Sure, it's taken 4.5 billion years for modern life to arrive on Earth, but the universe itself is some 13.8 billion years old. There's time and then some for life to have developed elsewhere then, and if more time really does equate to more advanced beings, which it may or may not, then there could be creatures on planets out there with more than twice what humans and the Earth have to work with, meaning many, many more advanced civilizations than our own. It almost certainly isn't as simple as all that, though. For one, the timescale for the development of human civilization really depends on where you start from. The creation of Earth billions of years ago, the first appearance of ancient hominins millions of years ago, the development of agriculture thousands of years ago, or someplace else. Theoretical civilizations could well advance at differing rates too, some slower and some faster than humans. Meanwhile, there's a concept known as the Great Filter to contend with, offering another explanation as to why space doesn't already appear to be creaking with intelligent life, despite the apparently vast statistical probability that there is other life out there. While the Fermi paradox asks, where are all the aliens, the Great Filter answers that there has to be a particular step in the development of life that's so rare that it almost never happens, or that it happened just once for our own case. It's a theoretical concept dialing down on whatever it is that seemingly prevents intelligent life from becoming common in the universe. There are a number of suggestions as to what this preventative structure could be. The chances of abiogenesis occurring anywhere could just be astronomical, or the chances of life developing and surviving for so long could be minuscule. Or there's the possibility that despite abiogenesis and evolution, all civilizations inevitably destroy themselves when they become too intelligent, and that's why we haven't found aliens yet. They've all killed themselves off. It's also why many are concerned that various human activities will soon bring about our own demise. We could be falling into the same trap, where our apparent intelligence becomes our downfall. The problem again, though, is that we only have one data point to go from, ourselves, and nothing to compare us to. So while it's wholly unlikely that we're the most advanced civilization there is, it's also not impossible. Similarly, we can't reliably say how long a civilization lasts once it becomes advanced either. We're obviously still here, but that's all we know. We, humankind, might have completed the Great Filter already, or we could still be passing through it, destined to one day disappear for whatever reason other advanced hypothetical civilizations apparently have done. The outlook is either promising or really rather bleak, but whatever the case, it adds another strand to this thought experiment, where humans could not only be the most advanced civilization right now, but also of all time, across the universe's entire history. Logic says that one civilization has to rank as the most advanced ever, so what if we're it? After all, from our perspective, there aren't currently any other candidates. Could we really be that unique? Well, as fun or frankly terrifying as it might be to imagine that humans are the most intelligent living thing there ever was, it's also extremely, extremely unlikely. At this stage, we can't even be totally sure that we're the first advanced beings on Earth. We've yet to find proof of any life outside of Earth, and given that when we observe other stars, planets, and galaxies in the sky, we are actually seeing them as they were however many light years in the past, if we ever did find signs of alien life, we'd only ever be seeing it as it was in its own ancient history. Bearing all of that in mind, there have been various studies to calculate just how special, or not special, we truly are. For example, one 2016 study by the physicist Adam Frank argued that the only way humans could be the first technologically advanced species in the history of the universe is if the odds of a civilization developing on habitable planets were less than 1 in 10 billion trillion. But most predictions have the chances of life as much higher than that. A 2020 study led by a team at the University of Nottingham, for instance, argued that there could be as many as 211 actively communicating civilizations right now in just our own Milky Way galaxy. If that's true, then human life, while still special, isn't unique, and could even be primitive compared to some of the others. Almost all calculations of this kind, however, depend at some point on how you apply the Drake equation, all of it or part of it, which we know is open for interpretation, bias, and inaccuracy. According to one multi-authored study in 2018, for example, titled Dissolving the Fermi Paradox, humans really could be a one-off. It used a parameter of values rather than exact numbers and concluded that humans are most likely the only intelligent species around, that our existence is so improbably incomprehensibly rare. On the other hand, there's the often cited infinite monkey theorem, the idea that monkeys randomly pressing keys on a computer could eventually type out the works of Shakespeare, which argues that given enough time, anything can happen, no matter how unlikely it might seem. So for civilizations more advanced than human beings, it just depends on whether 13.8 billion years is enough time. In truth, there's just too much uncertainty about almost all the key values required here to estimate where on a Kardashev-type ladder of advancement we might rank, or if indeed there are other civilizations out there to even rank alongside. With a sample size of 1, life on Earth, we just don't know enough about life in general, its properties and potential. Some will argue that it's exceedingly common, pointing out that we're so far one for one, that the only planet that we know of that's perfect for life, Earth, has successfully developed it. But at the same time, others see our being here as just the product of extremely good fortune and impossibly aligned circumstances. If we're so unlikely that we're actually alone, then we're naturally the most advanced. If we're not, if life itself is common, well, the odds that we're the superior ones aren't at all in our favor.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.